people united will never be defeated. The people united will never be defeated.
What kind of foreign policy should independent Scotland have?
It should have a foreign policy where it doesn't get itself involved in alliances that are going to take it to war, or going to have it in a situation where it's going to be supporting expeditionary wars by other stronger states.
Okay.
That's the key thing.
I'm an internationalist, not a nationalist, and I think that's a mistake that people make, that they think that when you want independence, it's a selfish thing. It's not. Obviously, we think it would be better for Scotland, but we also think our relationship with other countries would flourish as well. Because when everything goes through Westminster, for instance, the Kurds, a lot of the direct help we want to give them, we have to go through the Foreign Office, who are just not sympathetic at all. So an independent Scotland would be a bonus for other countries as well as us.
I think independence offers us an opportunity to have a radically different foreign policy than the British state is at the minute, and I would hope that, given our history, we would be an ally to self-determination movements around the world. I think right now Catalonia, for example, is desperately in want of international friends. I think if you see what's going on in Kurdistan, and then there's movements, you know, in Latin America and so on, where they're really fighting for their sovereignty in the face of like big global powers. And I think definitely independence can be part of a process of breaking those up and doing something differently.
I have leaflets here in support of the people who are protesting in Chile at the moment. I was out supporting some of the Chileans in Edinburgh yesterday as part of their demonstration, singing in solidarity with them. I think we have a long history in Scotland, of being oppressors and people who have really gone around spoiling the world, but B, as I suppose partly in reparation, trying to be in solidarity with people around the world. But I feel very, very strongly that we have to believe in international solidarity and support for those who, like ourselves, are trying to get rid of oppressors and who are trying to work for a just society where people are respected.
And obviously, in our own right, we're not huge and we're not going to really dictate to anybody else, but I guess if you have a nice, decent society yourself, you can maybe inspire others.
What about national self-determination in other countries? Obviously that's an issue in Scotland, but also in Catalonia, Palestine, Kurdistan. What relationship should Scotland have with those countries?
I think it'd be hard not to show some sort of solidarity with people that are trying to do the same thing as you're doing, obviously in more extreme circumstances than us, but it's the same kind of principle that people should have the right to self-determination.
Well, I would like to see Scotland to be a much more inclusive country and fairer. And I do believe that we can lead the world in trying to make it a better place. We could have a more positive role, but we've also got to be aware that we are a small country and our power is probably more not in terms of defence, but in terms of influencing things.
And would you like to see Scotland getting more involved in these struggles in Catalonia and Chile and Kurdistan, for example?
I think we should, yeah. I think we should. It's very clear that our opinion should be heard and we should offer solidarity to such movements.
Yeah, we've seen there's a lot going on in Latin America right now. You know, what kind of orientation should Scotland have on what's going on in Chile, Ecuador, things like that? What can people in Scotland do to support those causes?
I think in the first instance they have to inform themselves about what's going on. That's the first thing. And then they have to show through their institutions some degree of support for the movements, progressive movements in these countries. That's probably one of the main things. I think in the United Nations, an independent Scotland should align itself with countries that take a more honest approach to these matters.
What should people in Scotland be doing at the moment to support those in Chile, do you think?
Well, a very simple thing is to write to all of our MPs and MSPs asking them to make sure that we are giving out a clear message from both Scotland and from the UK that we don't think that the people of Chile are at war with their president, but that they are standing up for their rights. We could really say that very, very clearly. I think that's important. Yeah.